tell you about Ahab, the Arab, the Sheik of the Burning Sands. He had emeralds and rubies just a dripping off of him and a ring on every finger of his hand. He wore a big old turban wrapped around his head and a scimitar by his side. And every evening about midnight, he'd jump on his camel named Clyde and ride silently through the night to the Sultan's tent, where he was secretly meet up with Fatima of the Seven Bays, the swingin'est number one dancer in the Sultan's whole harem. Cause like him and her had a thing going, you know, and they've been carrying on for some time now behind the Sultan's back. And you could hear him talk to his camel as he rode out across the dunes. His voice would cut through the still night desert air, and he sung. Which is Aramic for whoa, babies. And Clyde say, well, he brought his camel to a screeching halt in the rear of Fatima's tent. Jumped off Clyde, snuck around the corner and into the tent, and he went. There he saw Fatima laying on a zebra skin rug, fingers and bells on her toes and a bone in her nose, ho ho. There she was, friends and neighbors laying there in all her radiant beauty, eating on a raisin and a grape and an apricot and a pomegranate, a bowl of chitterlings, two bananas, three Hershey bars, and sipping on an Arosico cover, listening to her transistor, watching the Grand Ole Opry and reading Mad Magazine while she sung, does your chewing gum lose its flavor? And Ahab walk up to her and he say, Ahab knew that this was the end. Him and Fatima was caught by surprise, and the Sultan had fire flashing out of his eyes. Well, the Sultan charged at Ahab, intending to make a dent in his head, but he fled with Fatima, and out of the tent they went. They jumped on Clyde and started to ride, cutting out across the sand, with the Sultan's whole army in hot pursuit, on and on the ran. Well, to make the long story short, they got away, cause there weren't no animal alive what could keep up Clyde once he got